Today we're making the most tender, flavorful, and juicy mini meatloaves with three flavor variations that you and your family and friends will absolutely love. I'm Whitney from SweetCayenne.com, and by the end of this video, you'll know how to make the best little meatloaves that are freezer friendly, reheat beautifully, and are so simple to make. I'm excited to make these meatloaves today with this one source ground beef from Zephyr Foods. They were kind enough to give me a sample of it, although this video is not sponsored. What I love about one source ground beef is that for every package of ground beef, you can trace it back to a single Black Angus cow on a US farm. That way you know exactly what's in your meat, where it came from, and you can rest assured that the animal was humanely raised and that the beef is going to be absolutely delicious. So what I love about these meatloaves is there are a few hidden ingredients in them that make them extra nutritious and also extra delicious. The first hidden ingredient is finely chopped carrots, mushrooms, and a little bit of shallot. Now I just diced them all up in the food processor, which made it really easy on me. And we're going to saute them up to kind of mellow out the flavor a little bit before adding it to the ground beef. And trust me, no one will ever know that so many veggies are hidden in these meatloaves. It also extends the amount of ground beef you have, so you're able to get a lot more meatloaves out of the mixture when you bulk it up with veggies like this.
Place a skillet over medium heat and add some oil just to coat the bottom of the pan. Once the oil is warm, you'll add your chopped veggies to the skillet. Then you'll want to saute them, stirring often until they're slightly softened, about 4 to 5 minutes. Once the veggies are soft, you'll add your flavorings. Add minced garlic, some Dijon mustard, followed by Worcestershire sauce and Montreal steak seasoning. Then you'll add some ketchup. And once all the flavorings are added, you'll mix it all together till it's well combined. And I find that mixing it all in the pan makes it much easier to incorporate the veggies and the seasonings into the ground meat so that you don't overwork the meat.
All right, so I've got 2 pounds of ground beef here in this bowl, and our veggie mixture has cooled off. You see it cooked down quite a bit, and we've got all of our seasonings already in here. The Worcestershire sauce, ketchup, everything, so that way it'll be much more easier to incorporate into the beef since it's already mixed into the veggies. So I'm just going to add this directly to the ground beef. There we go. Then I'll use a rubber spatula to scrape this off. And then to that, I'm going to add 1 large egg that's been lightly beaten. Just like that. And the egg acts as a binder to help the meatloaves hold together. And then another binder is panko breadcrumbs. So I've got 2/3 of a cup of plain panko breadcrumbs that I'll add right in there. And then I'm just going to use my spatula to gently break the meat up and mix everything together initially, but I think it'll probably be better to use my hands. Sometimes your hands are your best tool and you just gotta get in there and get a little dirty and it'll mix a lot better that way. You wanna be gentle when mixing though so that you don't overwork the meat and make your meatloaves too tough.
Last, you'll add some cubed white cheddar cheese, or you could use any cheese that you like. Feta, blue cheese would be delicious in this, or pepper jack. And then you'll use the rubber spatula to just gently fold the pieces of cheese into the meatloaf mixture, being careful not to overwork it.
So now that our cheesy meatloaf mixture is ready, it's time to shake them out. I'm going to be using 1/2 the mixture to shake to bake right away, and then I'm going to shake some to freeze for later. This is a great freezer-friendly recipe. You can just shake the meatloaves, freeze them on a tray, and then once they're frozen, you can put them in a gallon freezer bag or a baking dish. So you want the meatloaves to be about 4 to 6 ounces in size, and I like to shake them kind of like a football shape. And then you can even make a football design on them with ketchup if you're using them for game day. So I'm just gonna shake them up. And once they're shaked, If you wanted to get fancy about things, you could wrap each meatloaf in some bacon and have a bacon-wrapped meatloaf, and that would be fun. But they're delicious just as they are.
So I like to drizzle about a tablespoon of my preferred sauce. I'm using buffalo sauce here in a zigzag design over the top of each mini meatloaf.
So the three flavor variations I mentioned earlier actually have to do with what you put on top of the meatloaf. So to top them off and make them look really good, you can either use buffalo wing sauce, ketchup, or your favorite barbecue sauce, and all make equally delicious toppings. As you can see, I've already got some buffalo sauce drizzled on the first two meatloafs, so now I'll do the next two with barbecue sauce, and this is just a good smoky barbecue sauce that's really going to complement the flavor of the white cheddar cheese that's in the meatloafs. You could also use like an Asian teriyaki sauce, that would be delicious, because these meatloafs are so versatile. I've made them with ground turkey before, I've made them with ground venison. You can really make them with whatever ground beef you like, and even change up the vegetables that you mix into them. We did mushrooms, carrots, and shallots for these, but you could do red bell pepper, onion, leek. Sometimes I fold baby spinach and artichokes into these to make a spinach artichoke meatloaf. It's really a great recipe to just let yourself get creative and customize them according to what you like. So these are ready to bake. And then for our freezer-friendly meatloafs, I'm just gonna put a sheet of plastic wrap over this and then freeze them for about an hour until they're firm. Then I'll just pop them in a freezer-safe baking dish. And I'll have thawing and reheating instructions for you in the description box below. You just thaw them in the fridge overnight, and when you're ready to bake them, put your sauce on and you're good to go. So I'm gonna bake these at 425 for 25 minutes until the internal temperature is 155 degrees Fahrenheit. Ooh, our meatloafs are ready. You can see the cheese bubbling out of them, and these smell incredible. I absolutely cannot wait for you to try this recipe. They've been on my website, sweetcayenne.com, for a while now, and they have rave reviews. Kids especially like them. So if you're making these meatloafs for one person and freezing them in portions, or if you're making them for 2 or 10, I can promise you they're going to be a total crowd pleaser. Now, these taste delicious with roast potatoes and green beans or a salad. They also taste amazing with my Duchess potatoes recipe, so I'll link those for you in the description box below. Pretty much can't go wrong what you serve them with. Make sure you get all of those crispy, cheesy bits up off the pan and onto your serving dish, because that is the absolute best part. The moment's finally come and I get to try these. I really can't take it anymore because they smell so good. I'm gonna get myself a buffalo one because that's my favorite flavor. And dig right in. See, the cheese is gooey, gooey, melty, spilling out of that meatloaf. Mmm. That is incredible. Best meatloaf I've ever had, and who would have thought? I didn't even like meatloaf as a kid, but with all these delicious flavor add-ins and the cheese, even the pickiest of eaters will love these. I've got everything you need to make these mini meatloafs listed in the description box below, including a printable version of the recipe. And as always, you can find all of my recipes on sweetcayenne.com. In the meantime, why don't you check out this playlist for more easy dinner recipe ideas, and I'll see you in the next video.